We will be assembling the Northwoods log twin over twin bunk bed. It will require two people to do the assembly. Make sure you have all your pieces or boxes for a complete bunk bed. You should have two boxes of bunk bed end rails, one box of top side rails, and one box of bottom side rails, bed slats, and hardware. We will unpackage all the pieces and keep each of the box's contents separate. Packaged all of our components, and in the hardware bag you see we should have 16 bolts and an Allen wrench. All the bunk bed pieces are assembled using a mortise and tenon construction, which is the best joint that you can have. The tenon has a metal insert in it which accepts the bolt which comes through the log and the mortise hole. The metal to metal insert is much better than using a lag bolt which other manufacturers use. In an open area, start by taking one bunk bed end and one bottom side rail which has the holes in it and insert that into the hole on the end of the end rail. That person should also take the other bottom side rail which has no holes in it and insert it into the hole above the hole that you just put it into. Bolt the bunk bed ends to these rails, but only start the bolts a few turns as we need to keep everything loose until the very end. So we'll put the bolt. Now with one person holding both of the bottom side rails, the other person can get the other bunk bed end and assemble the bunk bed to these side rails, leaving the bolts loose. Take one of the top side rail assemblies and with one person at each end of the bunk bed, making sure the holes for the bed slats are down and facing into the inside of the bed, insert the tenons into the mortise holes on the bunk bed ends. Do this one end at a time. Start the four bolts only a few threads, leaving everything loose. Next we'll be getting six of the bed slats and the other bottom side rails. Spread the bunk bed ends outside out wider than the length of the side rails. Put a bed slat on the floor by each of the side rail holes. At the same time, one person will start putting the side rail tenons into the mortise bed holes while the other person puts the bed slat into the bottom rail. You'll put the bed slats in from one end going to the other end while also pulling the side rails into the center of the bed. Need to get the other top of the bottom side rail, inserting into one end, and then now that both of them are there, we will squeeze the two ends together towards each other into the mortise holes of the end of the bunk. Start the bolts a few turns, keeping everything loose. Now get the other six bed slats in the top rail and do the same as you did on the bottom. Working together at the same time, put the bed slats in the side rail holes as the side rail tenons are being put in the bunk bed end mortise hole. Push the bunk bed ends together once you've completed this and start the bolts. The bunk bed should now be assembled, and with the Allen wrench, you can tighten all the bolts as snug as possible. Turn all the bed slats so they are all flat on top. Using both people, insert the bunkie board on top of the bed slats, being careful not to scratch the log. Once you've completed this on both the top and the bottom bunk, you can move your bunk bed into its location in the bedroom. You have just completed the assembly of the Northwoods log bunk bed, which is the best-selling, best-built log bunk bed in the industry. We back this up by offering a lifetime warranty against defects in material and workmanship.